to another helping of Mr. H's Hot Pot. You join me today on Christmas Day here in the room where traditionally the H's have our Christmas lunch. But this year is a little bit different because, as you can see, my little son's arrived. He actually arrived on the 9th of December, didn't he, Mrs. H?
He did.
But due to him being born via emergency caesarean, I've just not had time to make this video and sort of welcome him into the world. But here he is. He was born at 1729, or 529, in the afternoon for those of you who work on the 12-hour clock. And he was a whopping, get ready for it, 11.7. Ooh, I don't know where you carried him for all that time.
No, especially that last week.
You know, there was quite surprised in the theatre, wasn't there?
Yeah.
When he was born. And apparently he came out fighting, he took a swing at one of the midwives when he came out. But, yeah, so I think Mick Byrne and another fella, you were the closest. I can't remember your name, sir, I'm sorry, but one of you did say £11, and we just thought he was joking at the time. You must have known something we didn't. But, yeah, he's here, and we're happy. We've named him Toby James. The reason I've named him James for the second name, before anybody starts any rumours, is my great-grandfather was named James Hope, and unfortunately, he passed away. They found him drowned in the canal. They don't know why, all them years ago in the 1800s, and he was buried in a public grave and there was no monument to him, so I thought, I'll give him something. I'll name him after him. So that's his name, Toby James. And he's been a little cracker for us, hasn't he, Mrs. H?
Yes, he's absolutely gorgeous.
I mean, you know, it's been hard work for the past fortnight. Like I said, I've been running about. For about a week, I was running up and down to the hospital, and Mrs. H's parents, on the day he was born, decided they'd go on a cruise, didn't they? They booked a cruise.
Yeah, it'd been booked for a year, though.
It was just sod's law type of thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, they went, so I had to run up and see to the cat, because I couldn't have cats here at my house with my dog, so I've just been running backwards and forwards. It got to a stage where I could just point the car at the hospital and say, you know, maybe we're there, you know, where to go, kids, type of thing. Bit of an art rider reference for those of you of a certain age. But yeah, and then the old jalopy, my car, decided to give up the ghost, didn't it? It's Buster Seal.
It has.
So luckily we're a two-car family, so I've had to jump in Mrs. H, and I'm doing all that running about. But because of the caesarean, you're not able to drive for, how long is it?
6 to 8 weeks, is it?
8 weeks, and that's going to be hard for you, because you love your driving, don't you?
Yeah, there's only 4 more to go.
Yeah, but we're getting there. Everything's sort of levelling itself out. He's not too bad for feet, is he? He's sort of going to a little routine of such. I mean, you know, obviously we're going up in the middle of the night making bottles. I'm the milkman usually, aren't I?
Yeah.
Making the bottles up for him, but he's worth it. He's worth every little sleepless minute. Aren't you, Toby? So really, like I said, we're going to get off in a minute, and we're going to get off and have our Christmas dinner at Mrs. H's mother's. So what I'd like to do, from myself, from Mrs. H, and from Toby James, is wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I hope Santa brought everything your little heart's desired. He certainly did the business for me and Mrs. H this year. And that's it, really. I'll be getting back in front of the camera, probably in the new year with normal service, non-baby related, because I don't want to bore you all with that chocolate and childbirth type of thing. That's just for me and Mrs. H. So, folks, until the next time, from myself, Mrs. H, and Toby James, it is bye-bye for now.